So I've darkened my room and let's take a look at a simple situation where we have the sunrise and the sunset and how the sun goes up in the sky and what happens to our subject if we only have one light source and this is the sun. This is what happens when the sun is rising. It goes up and I guess you can see how the shadows move in our subject. And on the ground, where the, let's say the table is the ground, and it slowly goes up, and then we have the noon sun, which is very harsh, very close to us. It gives us very harsh shadows on our subjects, and then it keeps going down. Where in the sunset, it kind of is diffused because it gets further away from the earth. And at some point it kind of sets away and we only get partial light, and that's it. So let's take a look at two other scenarios. One is when the sun is behind our subject, and you see what happens. You get a very bright spot behind your subject, and your frame or your picture will be overexposed, and your subject is very dark, so you're not able to capture anything of your subject, but rather you capture the backlighting of the subject. Now, as a beginner, maybe it's a good idea that you try to understand light better and then make pictures with the sun behind your subjects, because there is some real good pictures that you can create like that, but you need to have an understanding. Since light is directional, in this situation we can see how the light from my little sun that I have here goes only in one direction, and it hits our subject in the back, but there is nothing really hitting our subject in the front. So if you want to make a picture like that, it's a good idea to use a field flash with your camera. Set your camera to field flash mode so you have some kind of light coming towards your subject, and you have to balance it between the sun and your field flash. Another situation is, and that's how we always try to make pictures as beginners, is we have the sun right behind our camera, and this is how it looks like. Very nicely illuminated subject, very nicely, very nice even light, and of course there is a big shadow behind it, if you can see it, but this is another thing that you might want to think about, because it might ruin your picture, a huge shadow behind. So in this particular case, we have the sun coming from the east, or is starting to go up in the sky, and you can see on our subject we have a brighter spot on the side where the sun is coming from, or my lighting is in this case, and we have that light coming on this side, kind of going towards the other side, but it's kind of dark on the right side of our subject. Now, how do we achieve a nice even lighting in that situation? The sun is on one side and we only have darker spot on that side. Well, it's pretty easy. You get some kind of a reflector to go with that. A basic reflector, well, you can use anything. You can use a big sheet of paper, or depending on the size of your subject, maybe you want to buy a normal reflector. I'm showing you in this particular tutorial, I'm using a stretch canvas, and look what happens when I put the stretch canvas on that side. It just evens out my subject, because what happens is the light comes from that side, it hits our subject, but then it hits my reflector, and my reflector puts the light back into on the other side of my subject. And this is a very easy way to balance the light. Now, you see, I move it away and it gets instantly dark.